Hello everybody and welcome. We're in the theater today and we are going to perform Pokon for you. And I'm Josephine, this is Noemi.
Hi.
And this is Stefan and this is Guy. And Noemi and Stefan are dancers and Guy is a musician and they are going to perform Pokon for you. We're here backstage, so the stage where they're going to perform is just behind me. You can also see it there on the screen. And I'm here because I'm the choreographer of Pokon, and you won't see me on stage, but I'm the one who made all the ideas and movements for the piece that you're going to see. So, before we can start, let's see if you can create your own theater just where you are. You can turn off the lights or close the curtains and find a very nice chair or couch to sit on. Because when it's dark, with your imagination, you can enter another world, like you're falling asleep and you start dreaming. So be ready to join us. Okay. Could we rush a bit? Okay, so they are getting themselves ready. Let's close our eyes for a second and imagine a big, beautiful curtain in front of you with some very nice lights on it. And you're in your own theater now and the performance is going to start. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes. Very nice. Looking super good. Okay, we go. We go. Super fantastic. Cool.
Can you move a little bit closer towards the audience? And can you put the ladder on your back? And then lie on the floor with your, yeah, with your belly on the floor. Okay, can you turn to your left, a quarter to your left? Yes. And then can you move to the other side of the stage? But don't lose the ladder on your back. Yes, so it looks, yes, like a turtle, but a little bit faster. Oh, the ladder cannot touch the ground. Okay. Put it there. Build it up. No. Can you put it close to this wooden panel? Towards the table. Yeah. And can you climb the ladder? Oh, wait, from the other side. Can you give it to Stefan? And then also a little bit faster. Yes, and Stefan, can you wear it as a backpack? Can you put it on your back? So I guess, yeah, you have to put one arm. Yes, but still stay straight. Shoulders down, long neck.
Oh, hello. Sorry, wait. So, you just saw Stefan there with a table as a backpack. And what I really like about working with objects is that you can use them however you like. That this looks like a table doesn't mean you need to use it as a table. You can use it as a backpack or a boat or a hut. Or a shoe, or a toothbrush, or a drum kit, or a back scratcher, whatever you like. Maybe you also have some very nice ideas for the table. So I get ideas very often, and then when I have an idea, I write it down in this special book that I always carry with me. And when I need an idea for a new piece, I always look in this book for ideas. So for the next scene, I collected some objects that I really like. And together with the dancers, we looked very creatively how we can dance with these objects. And from the best ideas, we made the following scene.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, four. Thank you.
So in the last scene, we used many objects. And in the next scene, we did the opposite. We tried out how many things you can do with just one simple stick. Where can you use it for? As a pencil or a drumstick or a telephone maybe. So let's have a look at Stefan and Guy and see how many meanings you can recognize. I'm sure you can find many. Okay, so did you see all the things they did with the stick? Like the writing and the dough rolling, and maybe you saw many more. And I thought maybe it's nice with the small stick if we also see how we can dance with a very big stick to make it a bit more difficult. So we tried that, and to be able to dance with this big stick, Noemi and Stefan need to collaborate together very well to make all the lifts and jumps work and to make sure they don't fall on top of each other. So let's see how well they can work together. Guy? 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 Come on. No, Guy, you need to hurry when they go to that side. Okay.
So don't try and contain me, I'll never learn, I'll never learn your tongue. I will be the same, I'll stay forever young.
Thank you.
When I were a child, I'd never sleep, I'd never sleep at night. I'd be running wild, I'd toss and turn, I'd toss and turn with all my might. So don't try to contain, I'll never learn.
They are still finishing the scene, but I think it's slowly getting time that we also start moving a bit ourselves. So I will put this stuff on the side. And then I think it's time to get off your chair and go stand somewhere where you have a bit of space around you and really put your feet on the floor very nicely. So I had an idea about a storm, so I thought I'd make a dance about a storm, and I asked Guy to write a song about the storm. So he did, and we're gonna teach you, but let's first start with a small warm-up to make sure we're nice and warm. So let's start with our feet together and stick your arms high in the air. Good. And try to make yourself as long as possible. And even higher and longer, reach with your fingers so much that you're gonna even stand on your toes. And you look to the ceiling. Very good, and then your hands start wiggling. And with these hands, you're gonna make a small storm happening in one arm. So rub it a bit warm, and let's go to the other arm. Good, and then we're gonna make a storm a bit in our belly. And then a storm about the backside of our belly. Good. And then we're gonna jog a bit on our place. Jogging into a storm that is now still quite far away. And then we're gonna go with our knees towards our head. And with our heels to our hands. And then we're gonna go with the sides. Good, and we go on one leg. And you shake out the other leg. And other leg. Good, and we're put the feet together again. We're gonna wiggle our knees. Okay, good. And then I think we are ready for part one of the storm dance. So, the storm dance starts the same as Pokémon. So we start with these two hands, and we put our thumbs above each other, and then you start rolling the thumbs around each other. Very nice. Thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling. Then the next movement is like you hear a storm, but very far away. So you put your hand behind your ear, and you really listen. If you can far away hear a storm, and the other side. cloud, and then we're gonna make a storm with our arms around our head. Super good. And then it's like our 2 feet are glued to the floor, and then a gulf of wind comes from one side, blowing your upper body whoop, to the other side, and then the wind comes from the other side, and you also go whoa to the other side. Good, let's go again to the thumbs.
Thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling.
And we hear something very far away. And listen to the other side.
I can't wait, no.
And we make a wind around our head.
Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling.
And we are getting blown to one side. And the other side.
Tornado.
And let's do it a bit faster. And
thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs. I can't wait, no, I can't wait, no. Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, tornado, tornado.
One more time.
Thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling,
and you hear something.
I can't wait, no, I can't wait, no.
Wind around your head.
Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, tornado, tornado.
Okay, good. Then I think we're ready for part two of the storm dance. And part two starts with two hands up in the air. And your hands pretend to be the rain that is falling next to your body.
And the rain falls down.
And then we jump 3 times as high as you can.
And we're stamping and we're splashing.
Good. Then with your hands you collect a very big bulk of water until it splashes on your head.
I'm getting soaking wet.
And then you wash one armpit.
So I don't need
and the other
another
one.
Washing.
Okay, let's do that again. Hands
and
in the air.
And the rain falls
jump
down.
Jump 3 times.
And we're stamping and we're splashing.
A lot
I'm
of water on
soaking
your head.
Wet.
Yes, and we wash.
So I don't need another washing.
Good. Then you make hailstones of your hands.
And the hailstones high.
Nice. And then it's like you have a drum in front of you, and you, with the hailstones, they hit the drum.
Come crashing from the sky.
And then it's getting colder.
It's getting colder.
And 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 your knees are wiggling. Colder. And maybe your head, maybe your jaw can shake a bit. Ooh, so cold, because the storm makes it all very cold in here. Okay. Good. Once the second part.
So and the rain falls down. And we're stamping and we're splashing.
And
I'm getting soaking wet.
And now the washing.
So I don't need another
the
hailstones. And the hailstones high.
Come down.
Crashing from the sky,
and
it's getting colder,
and colder,
and colder,
and
colder.
Okay, very good. Let's do the whole dance together. So we start with the thumbs. Here it comes. And
thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs. I can wait, no, I can wait, no.
The wind around your head.
Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling.
And
tornado.
One side, the other side.
Tornado.
Again.
Thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs.
Nice.
I can wait, no, I can wait, no. Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling.
Woo.
Tornado.
Very big.
Tornado. And the rain falls down. And we're stamping and we're splashing. I'm getting soaking wet, so I don't need another washing. And the hailstones high come crashing from the sky. It's getting colder and colder and colder.
Okay, good. Let's do it one last time. And let's imagine this time that we also have audience. So there are people watching us. They're also very far away because there are a lot of people. So you need to make all your movements very big. When the wind blows you to one side, really glue your legs and go all the way. Let's give it a try. Hey. hands.
Thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling,
very
thumbs.
Big,
I can wait, no,
fun.
I can wait, no. Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, tornado, tornado. Thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs twiddling, thumbs. I can wait, no, I can wait, no. Wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, wind whirling, tornado, tornado. And the rain falls down, and we're standing and we're splashing. I'm getting soaking wet, so I don't need another washing. And the hailstones high come crashing from the sky. It's getting colder and colder and colder.
Nice, Guy. I think you need to go on stage again. You can give this to me. This will be okay. Okay, good luck.
Yep.
After seeing this, you feel inspired to create your own dance. And I would say this is
definitely something you should try at home or at school. And I think there are many things you can do. You can make your own idea book and write all your ideas in a book and try some of them out. Or you can make your own stick dance with a pen or with a broom or something that you find in the garden. Or maybe you can go to your living room, choose three objects that you really like and create a dance with them by dancing over them, under them, maybe take them through space. And then you can show it to your parents or your brother and your sister or your teachers to have your own audience. And most important, have some fun with it.